Okay, so in this video, pag-aaralan natin ngayon yung part 2 ng distance problem. So in part 1, pinag-aaralan natin yung mga definition of terms ng distance and then yung mga basic problems na may encounter natin sa distance problem. So in this video naman, ang pag-aaralan natin na is distance problem pero ang situation is if traveling in opposite directions. Okay, para mas maintindihan natin, let's have example number 1. Okay, a bus and a car leave the same place and traveled in opposite directions. If the bus is traveling at 50 miles per hour and the car is traveling at 55 miles per hour, in how many hours will they be 210 miles apart? Okay, so kung i-illustrate natin siya, ganito yung magiging itsura niya. Okay, meron tayo dito directions. So, yung daw bus, okay, let's say, sabihin natin na ang bus
papuntang east
and magta-travel siya at 50 miles per hour and yung car naman is papunta naman siya ng west at magta-travel siya ng 55 miles per hour. Okay, so magta-travel sila ng opposite direction. So ang tanong, in how many hours will they be 210 miles apart? So ilang oras ang aabutin bago sila magkaroon ng layo na 210 miles na magkalayo. Okay? So, meron tayong 4 steps na susundin sa pag-solve ng directions ng distance kapag nagta-travel ng opposite. Okay? Let's have step 1. Una, set up muna natin yung RTD table. Okay, we have here 4 columns. Yung unang column, nandun yung bus at yung ating car. Yung second column, nandun yung R or yung rate. And then, yung T is for time and then yung distance sa 4th column. Okay? Step 2, fill in the table with information given in the question. Okay, so lagyan natin ng mga information yung ating RTD table. Okay, yung rate ng bus natin is equal to 50 miles per hour. While yung car natin, magta-travel siya at the rate of 55 miles per hour. Okay, and then let our T is equal to time for both to travel 210 miles apart. Okay, so then, we have step 3 here. Fill in the values for D. Okay, so, anong ilalagay natin sa D? So, since ang formula natin sa pagkuha ng D is rate times time, imumultiply natin yung rate at time ng bus at ng ating car. Okay, unahin natin yung bus. Okay, so sa bus, 50 times T is equal to 50T. While yung car naman, R times T, 55 times T is equal to 55T. Okay, and then, okay, so, nakompleto na natin yung DRT table natin. Okay, ngayon, i-equate naman natin siya. Since ang total distance natin is 210 miles apart, i-equate natin yung 210 miles sa addition ng distance ng ating bus at ng ating car. Okay, so paano yon? So step 3, step 4, since the total distance is 210, we get the equation, okay, 50T plus 55T is equal to 210. Okay, and equate natin yung 210 sa 50T, which is the distance of the bus, and ini-add natin siya sa distance ng car, which is 55T, since ang total distance nila is 210. Okay, hanapin natin ngayon kung ilang oras ang magugugol nila sa pag-travel bago sila maging 210 miles apart. Okay, una, i-plus natin or i-add natin yung 50T plus 55T. We will get 105T is equal to 210. Okay, to isolate the variable T, we have to divide both sides by 105. Okay, so we have 105T divided by 105 is equal to T. And then 210 divided by 105 is equal to 2 hours. Okay, so therefore, our bus and our car will be 210 miles apart in 2 hours. Okay, so two planes leave the same airport at 8 a.m. Plane 1 heads to Palawan at 600 miles per hour and plane 2 heads Cebu at 450 miles per hour. How long will they be 1,400 miles apart? Okay, so illustrate natin siya. We have here direction. So ang ating plane 1 papuntang Palawan will be traveling at 600 miles per hour while yung ating plane 2 na papuntang Cebu is magta-travel ng 450 miles per hour. Okay, so ang tanong, ilang oras ang aabutin nila para maging 1,400 miles apart silang dalawa? Okay, so again, so we have four steps. Let's have first step, set up an RTD table. So we have four columns again. So sa first column, nandun yung ating plane 1 at yung ating plane 2. Second column, doon natin ilalagay yung ating rate. Third, yung ating time. And then yung fourth column is yung distance. Step 2, fill in the table with the datas given in the question. So sa plane 1, ang ating rate is 600 miles per hour, while plane 2 is 450 miles per hour. Okay, again, let our T be the time for both to travel 1,400 miles apart. And then, step number 3, i-fill in naman natin yung column ng distance. So since ang formula again ng distance natin is rate times time, i-multiply natin yung rate at time ng plane 1. So we have 600 times T, we have 600T. Sa plane 2, we have 450 times T, we'll be having 450 T. Okay. And then for our step 4, equate natin yung sum ng distance ng plane 1 at ng distance ng plane 2 dun sa total distance na 1,400 miles. Okay, so paano yon? Again, so sa step 4, equate 600 T plus 450 T to 1,400. Okay, so let's add 600 T plus 450 T. We will be having 1,050 T is equal to 1,400. Okay, to isolate the variable T, divide both side by 1,050. Okay, so kapag dinivide natin yung 1,050 T sa 1,050, kakancel out natin siya, matitira lang e yung T, and then 1,400 divided by 1,050 will give us 1.33 hours or 1 hour and 20 minutes. Okay, so therefore, they will be 1,400 miles apart in 1 hour and 20 minutes. So kung umalis sila, okay, so kung umalis sila ng airport ng 8 a.m., so in 9:20 a.m., meron silang distance apart na 1,400 miles. Okay, so that's it kung paano mag-solve ng distance traveling in opposite direction. Okay, so since the only way to practice, to learn math is to practice it, kayo naman yung magpa-practice mag-solve ng ating distance problem while traveling in opposite direction. Okay, so you have here problem 1, 2 cars leave from the same place at the same time and travel in opposite direction. One car travels at 55 miles per hour and the other at 75 miles per hour. After how many hours will they be 520 miles apart? Okay. Okay, so again, kailangan i-practice nyo naman yung natutunan nyo from this video. Okay, comment down your answer and then i-reply ko yung solution at para makita nyo kung tama ba o mali yung inyong sagot para ma-practice nyo ulit siya. Okay, so that's it. I hope natutunan kung paano mag-solve ng distance problem while traveling in opposite direction. Okay, so that's all for now, students. Okay, so thank you for watching and see you again next time. Kaya nag-like and nag-subscribe, please like and subscribe para laging updated sa mga latest videos natin.